All right, Shalom. First off, I want to start off by saying all praises, honor, and glory is due unto Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai, by Hashem, HaKadosh. All praises to the world called God, whose true name in the Hebrews, Yahweh, by Hashem, meaning in the name of Yahweh Shai, being the name of the only begotten Son. Also want to say double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone.
Peace and mercy
to the whole Felic preachers, word in truth and sincerity. I'm Brother Tazabah, the Great Millstone, Arizona Camp. Lord will with another video to edify. And, you know, we was talking, me and a brother today, and I sent this video to him. And, you know, this referred me back to a scripture. I think it's in Numbers that I'm going to get. Basically going into, you know, when the children of Israel were singing to the Lord, he came near. And that's exactly what we're doing right now, right? We're singing praises unto the name of the Heavenly Father. And he's drawing near, right? Some men are singing the song falsely, and the Lord isn't coming unto them, showing you that the spirit of prophecy isn't working in them. And other men, like the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, men under them that follow the same doctrine, are singing the right song, in the right tune, in its entirety, with the right notes. And the Lord is drawing near and filling the court with the cloud like he did in the past. Now I'm going to play this so you can hear it, because this is fire, bro. And then we'll get some scriptures, and Lord will this be edifying. What? 1 second, man. And that's how cold this song is, man. Everybody playing the right tune. And there's a camp of the Heavenly Father, a camp of the righteous, right, that are singing that tune in perfect note, just like that. But when this song is played right, like the scriptures say, my sheep hear my voice and they follow me, then the true believers get a hold of the message and they're like, yo, that's a sound I know. That's something in the spirit. Right? Now this is just to get a couple. It's not gonna be too long. This is 2 Chronicles 5. And 12. It says, also the Levites, which were the singers, all of them of Asaph, of Heman, and of Jeduthun, with their sons and their brethren, being arrayed in white linen, having cymbals and psalteries and harps, stood at the east end of the altar, and with them 120 priests, sounding with trumpets, just like they were. Right? We're sounding the trumpet. We're sounding an alarm against the fenced city. We're sounding the trumpet to be ready for the battle. We're sounding the trumpet for the pending victory. Because we go through all these things that are written in the scriptures. The woe, the pestilence, the warning. And we go into the scriptures that talk about the victory. Right? We're sounding the trumpet in the name of Yahweh Shemei Arshai. In all facets. It says, it came even to pass as the trumpeters and the singers were as one, right? Even it's going to come to pass where the trumpeters, right? And the singers is one. Where the trumpeters, where the singers, right? We're one spirit. When you go into GMS, there's no schisms and different breakdowns per whoever it is, per camp and everything like that. All the breakdowns are one. Yeah, so many breakdowns of IUIC, of what the mark is, who the son of perdition is. This is always changing, right? Then you have Sakari. Now they don't believe in Paul's writings, right? They think that you can wear hats when the scriptures say otherwise. They say contextual evidence doesn't point towards something when the scriptures just have it written for a reason. They're changing up that sound. It's not of one. We got to be one with the Lord, even as one with the Heavenly Father, as Yahawashi was one with the Heavenly Father. Right? Agreeing in all things in the scriptures. It says, and it came to pass, it came even to pass as the trumpeters and the singers were as one, to make one sound to be heard in the praising and thanking Yahweh. Right? There's one sound in the praising and thanking the Lord. Yahweh Shemayah Shai. Right? We say righteousness comes through the faith through them. But you have groups that say, oh, righteousness comes through the law, statutes, and commandments. Right? Well, if the righteousness came through the law, statutes, and commandments, the scriptures tell you. Right? None of us would be saved because what? All have fallen short. And if you fall short, you have to receive what? The judgment, whatever it be. And a lot of times it's unto death because we've gone so far off and we've been in this world for so damn long. It says, and when they lifted up their voices with the trumpets and the cymbals and the instruments of music and praised Yahweh, saying, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever, right? And that's what we're saying. Come back to the Lord. Do what the Lord said, that you can receive that mercy, that the Lord can show you, right? And open those blessings unto us, right? We're telling you, see that the Most High is good, that his mercy endure forever. That then the house was filled with the cloud, even the house of Yahweh, meaning what? The Lord came down just to hear. It says, so the priest could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud, for the glory of Yahweh had filled the house. Right? They couldn't minister because what? That spirit was just too thick in there, man. The Lord came down to hear that praise. Just like in the heavens when the Lord said what? They cease not day or night. The 40 and 2 elders cease not day and night. Then to praise the Heavenly Father. Right? And that's what we're doing on this earth. Because what did the scripture say? Out of the mouth of babes have thou perfected praise. Where are those babes? Where are those insignificant ones? The ones that are just seen as just regular guys. Which that's fine. We are. But if the Lord had chosen us, we're more than regular. We're more than normal. Right? Revelations 14 and 3 says, and they sung as it were a new song before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders. And no man can learn that song but the 144,000 which were redeemed from the earth. And those 144,000 going into the one third as well, right? That were redeemed from the earth were always chosen to get that song. So now we're back now, and brothers are blowing the horns. Brothers are singing the song, which is this word, the praises, and perfection, and one, and the Lord is drawing near, because we all getting more close to the Heavenly Father till some point, you know, we're just going to see that, hey, the Lord is 100%, right? With the sincere men of Great Millstone, because there's niggas crept anywhere too, man. It happens. The Lord said it would happen. Psalms 96 says, oh, sing unto Yahweh a new song. Sing unto Yahweh, sing unto the Lord, all the earth. Sing unto Yahweh, bless his name, show forth his salvation. From day to day, declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among all the people. For Yahweh is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but Yahweh made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Right? We're singing those praises. We're telling you who's bringing these things on the earth. We're telling everybody who the Lord is dealing with. We're going through the prophecies. This is a beautiful song to the Lord, because he's hearing his words in this earth being put out in the right way. Right? It goes further than just knowing that you're Israelite. Right? That's just the beginning. Now you got to go into the name of the Lord. Yahweh Bashimi Al Shai. Now you got to go into the keeping of the holy days we can keep. Having the right spirit, having the right mindset. Going into the prophecies of the mark of the beast. Right? Correcting our lifestyles. These are praises to the Lord. And these are the sounding of the trumpet. This is Psalms 144. It says, I will sing a new song unto thee, O power, upon a plastery and an instrument of 10 strings will I sing praises unto thee. It is he, the great, that giveth salvation unto kings, who delivered David, his servant, from the hurtful sword. So we're singing unto the Lord. We're playing this song unto the Heavenly Father and his Son, singing praises unto him. Right? Ephesians 5, and I'll end it on this one. Ephesians 5 and 19 is speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to Yahweh, giving thanks always for all things unto Yahweh, the Father, in the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of the Most High. Right? See, that praise, that singing, that's all happening in the spirit. And we're playing with that one sound. It sounded greater than this, and this sounds amazing. Fire, bro. This is going to be the type of music we have in the kingdom. Shalom.